ஸ்ரீகுருப்போ நம. ஹரி ஓம். ஓம் குங்குருப்போ நம. ஓம் கம் கணபதயே நம. ஓம் ஐம் சரஸ்வத்யை நம. ஓம் கணானாம் த்வா கணபதி கும் ஹவாமகே. கவிம் கவீனாமுபமஸ்ரவஸ்தமம் ஜேஷ்டராஜம் பிரம்மணாம் பிரம்மணஸ்பத ஆனஸ்ரண்மன்னூதிபிஸ்ஸீதசாதனம். ஓம் ஸ்ரீ மகாகணபதயே நம. ஓம் நமசிவாய குருவே சச்சிதானந்தமூர்த்தயே நிஷ்பிரபஞ்சாய சாந்தாய நிராலம்பாய தேஜசே. ஓம் யஸ்யாத்மபூதஸ்ய குருப்ரஸாதாத் அஹம் விமுக்தோஸ்மி சம்சாரபந்தாத் சர்வோபதிஷ்டு சிவானந்தமூர்த்தே மிருது அக்ரியுக்மம் பிரணதோஸ்மி நித்யம் தயாசிந்தும் தீனபந்தும் சாஸ்திரார்த்தபோதனபட்டும் மஸ்கரீந்திரவரம் நோமி ஸ்ரீச்சிதானந்தசத்குரும். ஓம் பிராணினாம் துக்கஹர்த்தாரு ஞானதோ புவனமுக்தயே சிவானந்தசிதானந்தோ ஆஸ்ரயே குருசத்தமோ. ஓம் ஓம் நமோ நாராயணாய. 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 ஓம் நமோ நாராயணாய.
ஓம் நமோ நாராயணாய. ஓம் நமோ நாராயணாய. ஓம் நமோ நாராயணாய. ஓம் நமோ நாராயணாய.
ஓம் நமோ பகவதே வாசுதேவாய. ஓம் நமோ பகவதே ராமச்சந்திராய.
ஓம் நமோ பகவதே வாசுதேவாய. ஓம் நமோ பகவதே ராமச்சந்திராய.
ஓம் நமோ பகவதே சிவானந்தாய. ஓம் நமோ பகவதே சிதானந்தாய.
ஓம் நமோ பகவதே சிவானந்தாய.
So we have been going through the second chapter, the Sadhana Pada of Patanjali. Patanjali starts with his Sadhana Pada, Tapasvadhyaya Ishvara Pranidhanani Kriya Yoga. Tapasya Swadhyaya and Ishvara Pranidhana constitute the Kriya Yoga. Austerities, study of scriptures, and adoration to God, devotion to God constitute the Kriya Yoga. And this will help you to turn your mind inwards and remove all your problems. What are the problems? Problems are the thoughts. Those thoughts which are disturbing you, that can be eliminated. Dhyanaheyaha tadvrtayaha can be eliminated. How to eliminate that? By the practice of the yoga angas, yoga anga anushtanat, asushikshaye jnanadiptihi avivekakyatehe. By the practice of the yoga angas, you can eliminate those impurities. When the impurities are washed away, knowledge will dawn. What are the yoga angas? Yoga angas are 8, yamaniyama asana pranayama pratyahara. தாரணா தியான சமாதியோ அஷ்டௌ அங்கானி. யமா நியமா ஆசன பிராணாயாம பிரத்யாகார தாரணா தியான சமாதி. தீஸ் ஆர் தி 8 லிம்ஸ். வாட் ஆர் யமாஸ்? யமாஸ் ஆர் 5 ஃபோல்டு. அஹிம்சா சத்தியமஸ்தேயம் பிரம்மச்சரியம் அபரிக்ரஹா ஏதே யமாக. நான் இன்ஜரி, ட்ரூத்ஃபுல்னஸ், நாட் ஸ்டீலிங், செலிபசி, and not hoarding, not coveting, constitute the yamas. These everyone has to follow. They are the great vows to be followed by one and all. Sarvabhaumaha mahavrataha. And this is not prescribed for any particular person or category or some place or some point of time. They are applicable to all people at all times. Then he goes to niyamas. Shaucha santosha tapaswatya ishvara pranidhanani niyamaha. Cleanliness, contentment, and austerities, study of scriptures, and ishvara pranidhana, surrender to God, constitute the niyamas. Then he says, your disturbances, the chitta vikshevas, are there because of the impressions. And whenever those thoughts come, whenever the disturbance comes, whenever there is a tendency to do wrong thing comes, then he says, pradibakshabhavanam. Vitarkabhadane pradibakshabhadanam. When the negative thoughts come, you have to entertain the positive thoughts and to counter it. And you think about the consequence of that. What are the consequences, he says. Then it is dukkha, ajnana anantapalaha, tarkaha, himsadeha, kritakarita, animoditaha, mrutumatyadimatraha. Then these are, you yourself do this, you make other person do it, you endorse it, all these things. When there is a tendency to break the yamas, breaking the yama itself is the wrong thing. All ultimately, all code of conduct boils down to the breaking the yamas or the wrong things. Observation of the yamas are the code of conduct. Whether it is national code of conduct or individual code of conduct, religious code of conduct, all the religions invariably proclaim this only. All the law of the nation, no nation will say, you go and steal. No nation can have a constitution like that. Whosoever can steal, let him be happy. So ultimately, all the social laws, all the governmental laws, all the religious codes of conduct are ultimately for the observation of Yama. And then he says this, whenever there is a tendency, because there is a human tendency to do wrong thing, as there is goodness in you, there is the wrong tendencies are also in you. As there is the divine in you, there is the animal in you. So conquer the animal tendencies with a firm will. Then he says, as you practice, now you know what are wrong things. No one will do anything wrong without knowing it. Knowingly we do wrong things. And so whenever there is a tendency there, you curb it with thinking about the opposite. And you have the ability to do it, and you do it at some point of time. Do it at every time. Then he says, as you get established in these things, then you will find there is a progress also. You will find the scale is given to you. You can find out how far I am progressing. Ahimsa pratishthayam tatsannidhau vairatyagaha. When you are established in ahimsa, in your presence, there should not be any violence. So I've been dwelling on that little yesterday. Little more I shall. Years before, I used to read Gandhiji's books. And then in one of his books, they say that Gandhiji was staying in the Vardha ashram. And there used to be a lot of scorpions. So once an inmate saw a scorpion and he was about to kill that. And when he was about to kill that, another person told, no, don't kill that. It is himsa. The other person told, no, this we can kill, otherwise it will kill us. So there was an argument. And they did not kill. Then later on, whether we can kill scorpion, cobra, if it comes, what will we do? Whether can we kill that? This question was put to Gandhiji, whether we can kill scorpion, he said. Gandhiji said, they won't harm us, that's all. The question was whether we can kill or not, whether it is ahimsa or himsa, whether this himsa is permissible or not. That was the question indirectly asked. instead of giving a direct answer, yes or no, Gandhiji did not say anything. He said, they won't harm us. No, they won't harm us. I was wondering why he did not give an answer, yes or no. He should have given an answer, yes or no. Why he did not give? Why? This was disturbing my mind. Then I forgot. Later on, I came to know, when I studied this Yoga Sutras, then I understand that they will not harm you. If you are established in Ahimsa, they will not harm you. If somebody does something wrong to you, can you think that I have some weakness, that is why it has happened like this? If you enter in my room and take my money, instead of calling you as a thief, can I consider that my purity is not enough? That is why he has taken this money. Can you think like that? Is it possible? We think that this fellow is a useless fellow. He is a wrongdoer. Why not we think that I am not able to influence him? When you advise a person and if he doesn't hear, if he doesn't accept your advice, instead of saying he is a scoundrel, he is such a negative person, he will never adhere to anything, instead of saying like that, probably my presentation is not that good. I am not able to make him accept my theory. Can you say like that? Will it be possible for you? Or do you consider that such thing is possible? These are certain vital angles of your vision. Vital angles of. One story I will tell you, not to glorify that, but still I feel this is okay with you. I used to sit just opposite the reception counter, in that room. Opposite that room, I used to sit there. And I used to carry a bag, this bag will be always in my chair. And somebody comes and asks some money and other things, I will take from this. We used to sit in the evening also. So one day evening we were sitting there, we were sitting in the inside room. The outer room were vacant. Then after some time, three people are sitting in the room. Suddenly we heard that our phone has fallen down. When the phone has fallen down, we came and saw one man is holding the phone. And he has pulled it. The wire has broken and the receiver fell down. Then he asked, what are you doing with this? Then he said, I came here to get a free kambal. Acha? You came to get, what are you doing with the phone? I just telephoned. Then someone asked, is it your telephone too? He was a thief. And then immediately one person asked me, Swamiji, where is your bag? My bag is missing. Then I asked, did you take my bag? No, he said. Why you came at this time at 7:38? Nobody comes at this time. Somebody told me, who are those people? Three people told me. Then he has taken my bag. I could guess that. So they told the police station. The police came and inquired. He said no. But from his eyes I could understand that he has stolen. Then who came? They said, that man came. He took the police people outside and he was showing all good people, this man came like. And he took them up to another 5 kilometers that side. And then there was some commotion there, the police were looking there, this fellow ran away from there. He came this side. In fact, he came first and took my bag. And he opened and saw nothing was there. Only some books and 1, 2, 3 paper covers. In that cover I have kept money. He doesn't know about it. So he thought nothing is there. So he kept it underneath a stone somewhere. He hid it on the Ganga bank and came again to steal. And when the police came, they asked me, Swamiji, have you got anything in that? Like, no, my mobile and some money was there. How much money? I do not know. Maybe 5,000, 6,000 rupees. Is it? So he came to know that money is there. I could not see. He might have thought. Then it was there. So then he ran away. Then what happened? The people who were with me, they were criticizing me all the time. You put this bag there, whenever whosoever comes, you take the money and give. And somebody comes and says, okay, go. I used to give. So that is why everybody knows. And then I said, what? Every time I cannot go into the room secretly, take what is there to lose, let it go, I said. Again, they were criticizing. Somehow this thought came in my mind. I told them, if I throw the bag here, nobody should touch it. If they touch it, it is a sign of my impurity. If my bag is lost, I will go for austerities, he said. I told them very vehemently. I do not know. I just told like that. And I came here and I decided if it is lost, I'm not going to worry about it. That's not a big money. I don't need also. I don't need any money. Then, actually that man came and took the bag and he was about to go. One of our old students was there. He saw that this is Swamiji's bag. He caught hold of him. And he got the bag and gave it to the police. And the police telephoned to me, Swamiji, your bag is intact. We are sending it to you. I don't say this to glorify myself. I don't say that I'm a God man and all these things. I'm an ordinary person. But you see, you should have that courage. You should have that inner feeling to see that it is possible that I am wrong. We always try to justify ourselves. I am right and you are wrong. There is a possibility that you are right and I am wrong. So the ancients believed that my presence should influence you. No, Swamiji is there, I will not do that. You should say that. My purity should be such that I should influence you without speaking a single word. So if you are established in that ahimsa, then in your presence nothing wrong should happen. So that is actually, Patanjali says, ahimsa pratishthayam tatsannido vairatyagaha. You know that there is a famous literature called Les Mirabilis. A criminal, a scoundrel, he steals from the chapel the golden candle stand and he runs away. The father goes behind. He was caught by the police and he says, he has forgotten to take this. What is this? This man is saving me. That brought about a change in the other person. These are not stories. There is a book called Peace Pilgrimage. A lady in the America, in the United States, she was wandering alone, like the monks in India. She was wandering alone. And once she came across, she had an encounter with a drunkard. And then she smiles at him Then he removes the bottle and see. Do you smile at me? Yes. Do you really smile at me? Yes. Do you really smile at me? He throws the bottle. Never in his life he has seen a person looking at him with an eye of love. So first time he encounters a person knowing fully well that he is a drunkard and out of control, someone smile at him. And the total truth in that smile, that brings about a change in his life, actually. The book is available in our library. Don't read big philosophy, you will not understand. Purnamadaha Purnamidam. You will never be able to understand Purnamadaha Purnamidam unless you understand the basic lessons of life. Without Yama, you cannot have the Samadhi. These are the basic lessons. You find such things, simple, simple things, how people are converted. The scoundrel will become a saint. So a saint will be the cause for making him. So in the presence of such a person, no enmity. If I am here, you should not quarrel with each other. If you quarrel, my purity is not enough. So that is actually the test, the highest test, acid test. So as you progress, as you are progressing in your spiritual path, you should evaluate yourself. How far my presence is influencing this? Not by my words, my presence will influence you. So that should give you that peace. Oh, Swamiji, I sit at your feet, I have so much peace. That should be the statement. I talk to you, you blessed me. No, my presence is my blessing. That should be your sadhana. So if such a person is there in a family, the family is blessed. The society is blessed. So we want such people actually. So it is, you have to do, you cannot change this whole nation. You have to change yourself, the nation will follow you. One Gandhiji could influence so many people. So many people he could influence. So ahimsa pratishthayam tatsannido vairatyagaha. Then he says, as you practice the next satya, satya pratishthayam kriyaphalashrayatvam. Satya pratishthayam kriyapalashrayatvam. If you are established in satya, satya pratishthayam, kriyaphala means, kriya means action. Actions, fruit of actions. Whatever I say should become true. As you are established in satya, whatever you speak, it should become true. Somebody says, Swamiji, bless me. Don't worry, everything will be all right. If I say that, it should become all right. If you are keep on telling lies, it won't become all right. So if you speak truth alone, then naturally it has to become true. If I say it is evening, it should become evening. The nature should abide by my commands. The sun will set now, if we say the sun should set. Satya pratishthayam kriyaphalashrayatvam. There are so many stories in the Puranas You know, there's a famous character in the Mahabharata. His name is Bhishma Pitamaha. This Bhishma Pitamaha was on the side of this Duryodhana. When Duryodhana goes to Sri Krishna, Arjuna, both of them went together to ask for his help. Then Sri Krishna says, I will come alone, I will not take weapons. I will give my army. Which do you want? You can prefer. So Arjuna preferred, you come alone, you be my chariot driver. This Duryodhana said, very happy, all the army will come to me, big army, that is okay. When he comes and reports this matter to Bhishma, he says, what a fool you are. Why you opted for that army? You should have opted for Krishna. What is the use of Krishna, Swamiji, Pitamaha, that he will not take weapon? The army is good, he said. Then he thought, what a fool you are, there is no point in telling you. Then he became angry with Sri Krishna. If he had opted for this side, the war would not have been there. So he is working against me. I don't want the war, but he wants the war. So he became angry with him and he said, had he told you that he will not take weapons? Yes, I will make him to take weapons, he said. I will make him to take weapons. And later on there was a war between Arjuna and Bhishma. At that time, Sri Krishna has to take the weapon. He takes the weapon. That picture you might have seen. But sir, there's a graphic description of that, not there, but later on, when Bhishma was about to die. Bhishma was in the bed of arrows. Sharashayya, they call it as. And after the war was over, he lived for quite some time. And then during the Uttarayana period only, he passed away. He could hold on to his life until that period, good period. So when the war was over, Yudhishthira had the doubt that I was responsible for killing so many. So he was worried. And then they did some prayaschitta. But he was still worried, I was responsible for killing so many people. So everybody clarified it. So it is inevitable, it has happened. Vyasa clarified, Krishna clarified, everybody clarified. But still the doubt was there. Then Sri Krishna says, let us go to Bhishma. He is the one who knows the law, the dharma very well. We will go to him. So they go there. When they go there, Bhishma Pitamaha saw Yudhishthira and all the Pandavas, Sri Krishna and all these people are standing. Why you came here? Then this doubt is there, he said. Your doubt has been clarified by Vyasa himself, then why do you come to me? Then he says, do you know why you have come here now? He says, this Sri Krishna wanted that your doubt should be cleared by me only, not by anybody. That is why your doubt persisted. And why he thought that way? Because in the last moment of my life, he wants to give me darshan. So he wants to come here. So he doesn't want to come alone, so you have brought all of you here. Then he says, don't worry, I will clear all your doubt. And until I clear your doubt, until I breathe my last, let him stand here. Pratikshatam yavaditam hinomyaham. Yavati idam hinomi, until I leave this body, let him wait and see. The command he gives like that. You go behind God begging. Can you tell him, you come and wait for me, can you tell him? You should have that courage. You should have that backup to tell God to wait until I want to see you. Until I breathe last, you be here, you should be able to tell. What a character, you see. You don't come across with characters like that who can command God that you wait until I breathe the last. People say, and in the last moment of life, may I remember you. What type of prarthana is it? It is a beggary. I say that until I breathe last, you be here. My life is such that you have to obey my command. I have sacrificed everything for you. Now I give you the command. You obey me. You know, there is a statement in the Bible. I have glorified thee on earth. Now thou glorify me. You glorify me. I don't want to glorify you anymore. You be here until I breathe last. I will continue it tomorrow. Hari Om.